EcoFlow's original shtick was to ditch the gas generator. And shortly after creating a product that did just that, they realized, hey, to back this thing up when there's no sun, we might just need a gas generator. So they created this thing. This right here is the OG EcoFlow Smart Generator. This thing was far from perfect. This one specifically is actually a dud, and EcoFlow is refusing to help us or replace it. Our other OG Smart Generator, though, might have some of the highest field tested hours out there with over 300 and climbing, and it's currently the one that you guys saw in the video backing up Josh's tiny home. But even Josh has questioned his purchase from time to time.
Sweet, what a sick unit.
Don't you just love the smart generators?
It's not even going.
So can EcoFlow redeem themselves with this new smart generator 4000? Then why should you even consider this thing instead of just getting a regular gas generator? So welcome back to the lab, where our opinions cannot be bought. It's getting to be that time of year again where the sun is just becoming less reliable. And if you need to back up your system, running a gas generator to back up your batteries might actually be a great move. And the reason you might consider going for the EcoFlow smart generator instead of just a regular gas generator is because this one has a port on the side strictly dedicated to passing power through to other EcoFlow products, and you skip the DC to AC conversion process. Basically, on one full tank of gas, if you're powering an EcoFlow product, it's gonna be 40% more efficient than if you're powering another product. And it also has automation. So this thing, you can program your Delta Pro 3 to automatically turn this generator on and charge it to a certain percent and then turn the generator back off. So you can basically have a hands-off operation, or so they claim. We've had this thing for a little while now. We've run it through a ton of testing. We have froze it completely solid. We've tested it with a bunch of other EcoFlow products. And as always, we have some links and coupon codes for you guys down in the description. Anything we can get out of EcoFlow to help save you guys some money if you're interested in buying it. But before we jump into our experience and all the things that we just don't like about this new version, we're gonna jump into a super quick spec teardown to get you guys up to speed with the brand new Smart Generator 4000. First up, this thing weighs 83 pounds, so it does pass the tiny baby lift test, but it is quite a big Bertha, so it's a little bit awkward. It only outputs 120 volts, and it's rated for 3,200 watts of output on gas, 2,900 watts of output on propane, and it says it has a 4,000 watt X-Boost, but we all know X-Boost is fake news. On the side here, you have your plug that goes directly into another EcoFlow product. On the front, you have your regular 120 volt house plug, and you do have a 30 amp on the front as well, although it's not a true 30 amp because this does not output 3,600 watts consistently. It has a 6 liter fuel tank, and it starts a million different ways. The big deal with this thing is the automation. You can manually start it by going ahead and giving it a tug on the pull cord. You can auto start it by just pressing the button here on the front and it fires itself up. You can start it with the app, which is basically the same thing. It's just sending a remote signal to do the electric start. And you can start it smartly. Basically, when it gets to a certain percentage, it'll signal to this guy. This guy will turn on and charge it. You don't have to do anything. This guy finally has a nice suitcase handle and a nice set of wheels in the back, so this one's actually easy to move around. And in the box, it comes with most things you need to get started, including the EcoFlow adapter, so you can plug this into basically any EcoFlow product on the market, except the Delta Pro Ultra. They lied about that. And you can get all of this for $17.99, though we did get some coupon codes, whatever. Check out the links in the description if you're interested. We'll try our best to save you guys a little bit of money.
Give it just a vicious pull.
But before we jump into our opinions on this thing and all the things we still just don't like about it, we put this through some vigorous testing, and we want to share those results with you guys because that is kind of the most important part when it comes to this guy. So starting with just the basic necessities, general functionality, starting this thing with the button, it usually primes 2 to 3 times on gas before it actually tries to start itself. So it's usually the fourth or fifth actual like turnover that it goes ahead and starts. Exact same story if you slide it on the app and turn it on that way. It's just remotely telling it to do the same function. When you have it hooked up to propane though, and you press this button, it basically fires up first try right away every time, which is really nice. And the pull start works, but there's no choke, so sometimes it takes a few good pulls to actually get this thing going. And then getting right into our favorite test that we put this thing through was cold weather testing. If you're using a system like this, chances are the fact that you don't have sun kind of coincides with the fact that it's getting colder outside. That's the main issue that Josh was always running into with the one at his cabin. It never auto started during the cold weather, which is 50% of the selling point in the first place, because it just wasn't good enough to do so. So to get started, we threw this thing full tank of gas into the freezer. After about a day of it just being completely frozen, we took it outside and we tried to get the DP3 to basically communicate with it to auto turn it on. And it didn't really work so well. The cool thing is that the auto start did try a ton of times. It threw a code right away when you turn it on. You can see there that it's got like the frost warning on it. But after multiple failed attempts for this thing to actually go ahead and start itself, which is the same issue the OG ones were having, we went ahead and tried to pull start it. But even then, it's still kind of a pain in the ass because there's no choke. So this thing, even after a few good pulls, it'll come on, sputter for a sec, and turn itself off. When it's cold, it's very frustrating to get this thing going. Once it does come to life though, it is vicious. It bypasses all eco mode that's turned on and everything, and it just runs like a bat out of hell for like 3 to 5 minutes. And something else that's important to know is once it does finally turn itself on, it won't put power out of this DC port to charge whatever it's plugged into for about 5 to 10 minutes after it's been running. So if you're gonna use this to charge up your system, you're gonna wanna get it going in the cold before your system's almost dead, because by the time it actually starts outputting power, it might be pretty close. Now, seeing that this thing actually started way better on propane, we decided to duplicate this test again, but try to start it in the cold with propane. So we did all the same things. After about a day of it being frozen, we pulled it outside, hooked it up to the Delta Pro 3, tried to get it to send that signal over, and it actually worked. It took a few primes. But it fired up and it was insane. This thing was dancing all over the driveway. This time it was running violently, but it was running. We never had to pull start it or anything. It was able to do it all on its own. Same story, it takes 5 to 10 minutes of it running to actually start outputting power. But if you live in a cold climate, I would actually recommend that you use propane just based on that result. It's something that Josh is actually going to switch over the one at his cabin to propane after seeing the results of how this went down. Next up, we tried the automation of this guy. We just plugged it into a bunch of EcoFlow products to make sure that it actually worked with them. So when you go in the app and you tell whatever product to turn on the generator at 30% and then turn it off once that product reaches 50%, it actually works with the Delta Pro 3, with the Delta 3 Plus, the Delta 2, the Delta Pro. The only thing it actually didn't work with was the Delta Pro Ultra, which we called to find out if we could get some sort of adapter. And they basically told us, just buy this adapter, no problem. And we had to explain to them like, hey dude, we're sitting here with the adapter in our hand and the unit in our hand, and it doesn't plug into the Delta Pro Ultra. Just know that right now they do not sell an adapter for the Delta Pro Ultra. I'm sure it's pretty easy to just make an adapter, but if you call them and you ask or whatever, they're telling people that it works, and I don't want people out there spending money on both of these to find out that they do not work together. And when it comes to just idle sound and roughness, this thing's pretty loud. It's as loud as a shitty Champion generator. The eco mode obviously is a bit quieter, but regardless, this thing runs very loud and it runs very rough. It's hard to see in like a full frame shot, but when you get a shot looking down the side of this thing, it's just jittering and gyrating all over the place, way more than the other generator that we were running, which is strictly a gas generator. I think the feet underneath are just way too squishy. They let it move too much. And another thing that we were curious about with this was, can you run a load off one of these front plugs while you're using the side port to charge another EcoFlow product? And the answer is yes, kind of. I think they want it to work, but it doesn't work that well in reality. So basically, this has an output of 3200 watts on gas. We had it plugged into the Delta Pro 3. It was putting 3200 watts into that unit. When you go ahead and plug something into the front of this, it knows it wants to prioritize these plugs, but it has a hard time doing it. We found that it would pull wattage out of the Delta Pro and it would start prioritizing these plugs, but after a couple minutes, it always threw a fit. It started jittering and it actually shut itself right down.
See if that one will dim if we turn on the others.
Oh my God, why, dude?
Every time, basically. It doesn't like to do it. And the final test that I wanna know is how fast can you actually swap between gas and propane? If you have a full tank of gas and you're connected to a propane tank, can you literally just switch it over? And the answer is yes. Which is really cool. If you have both hooked up and you run out of one, it takes you less than 30 seconds to switch it over and fire it back up. When it comes to things that we like about the Smart Generator 4000 though, the first one, the most noticeable thing to me was that it runs much cleaner than the previous generation and than a regular gas generator. Even the previous generation, the first time I ever turned it on, it smoked like crazy. This one, we've been beating on it all kinds and it's never smoked on startup yet. I also like that the pull start on this guy, I can't do that because it's currently turned on, is really, really smooth. A lot of generators, they have like that point where they kind of catch and they try to kill you.
Broke his fucking leg, dude.
This one doesn't do that. It's a really smooth pull. It's really easy. You know, like all the diabetic retirees probably love pulling on this thing. I also really like that it came with the adapter for basically every EcoFlow product but the Delta Pro Ultra. With the wheels and the suitcase handle, this thing is way more portable than the previous versions were. And I also just like the service doors. They've added a top one up here, so it's really easy to get in there, change your spark plug, do that kind of stuff. The app works great. It allows you to turn it off, turn it on. You can input settings actually for your propane tank size as well. And then this can read, I guess, the pressure on your propane tank. It tells you what percentage your tank is at, which is pretty cool. When we first started, it was just saying this 88888 across. But once we actually put in our settings, it was able to adjust and read the percentage of propane that we had left. When it comes to things we don't like, the first one is that it just runs really, really rough. The feet are way too squishy and big underneath this thing. It dances, it jiggles, it vibrates all over the place. It does the classic, it's the same thing every smart generator has basically been doing, where it does a weird ramping up and down of the RPMs straight out of the box. Our OG one, that was the first thing it did when I fired it up. This one is the exact same story. Sometimes in the middle of it running, just for absolutely no reason, it'll just start fluctuating and ramping up and down. Sometimes it even just turns itself completely off and then the auto start won't work. You have to go manually pull it to turn it back on, which is frustrating because if it auto shuts itself off and you're not around, it won't turn itself back on. You kind of buy these things to rely on the automation features and they still haven't ironed that out. Another huge one that we don't like is that most people, when you have some sort of setup, you're gonna have it against like the interior wall of your house. So if it's in your garage, for example, you're not gonna put your Delta Pro 3 against your garage door. You're gonna put it against the far side of your garage, against the house, because that's where all your wiring and everything will pass through if you have like a transfer switch or something. And the cable that this comes with to connect to your units is only 16 feet long. An average garage is like 18 feet at least. Our garage is like 22. So you can't put this generator outside without moving your system closer to the door, which in some circumstances is no big deal. If you just don't have like a full system and you just have your Delta Pro 3 in the kitchen because a hurricane just came through and you're trying to keep your fridge and your router and stuff on, you'd have to have it in your kitchen, but move your fridge close to the back door so that you could also have the cord running through the back door to get this outside because it's not a very big cord. Then it has your communication cables and everything running through it, so you can't just snip it and add length. It's kind of a dumb feature. Overall, if you don't live in a cold climate, the automation works really, really well. And I think this is a really sick unit to have, even if you do live somewhere like us. Pull starting at the odd time is very annoying, but at least you can always rely on it turning itself off. even if you have to be manually starting it every time, it'll still turn itself off when it hits the whatever mark you have your unit set to be at. So for that, it does gain some extra points. We still think EcoFlow has some work to put in before the next generation, but as of now, I still think it's a pretty cool unit, flaws aside. That is all we got for you guys. There's some links in the description down below if you want to check this thing out. I will catch you next time. Thank you so much for watching. Peace out and stay charged.